Ahoy, Big Bang Theory fans. As you all know, our favorite show has depicted some of the best friendships on TV, but Penny and Amy's bonding was my most favorite. I really loved the way these two girls influenced each other, stood by each other, and shared some lovely bestie moments that we, as the audience, could hardly forget. So let's check out some of those times when Penny and Amy were actually hitting those friendship goals hard. Amy bought a small gift for Penny. Guys, you would remember that episode where Amy brings a portrait for Penny as a token of friendship. Many fans have agreed with Penny that the portrait is ugly, mostly because of its size and style. However, the portrait only reflects Amy's genuine affection for Penny. Penny was also nice on her part and hung the portrait on the wall despite disliking it. Why do you think Penny disliked the portrait? Well, I think there's a hidden meaning to the portrait. Those days, Amy had a girly crush on Penny, and you will understand this if you notice Bernadette's remarks. Bernadette told Penny that Penny is looking like a man in the portrait, so that portrait actually depicts a lesbian couple, in which probably bothered Penny even more. Penny realizing that Amy is her BFF. As you know, Amy has always been vocal about her friendship with Penny and was never shy to admit that Penny is her BFF. I think Penny took a long time to realize her affections for Amy. You guys would remember that episode when Leonard was happy that Sheldon had asked Leonard to be his best man at their wedding. Penny was sad that Amy chose Bernadette as her maid of honor, but wasn't admitting it. When Leonard confronts Penny that she is sad, Penny brushes it off, telling Leonard, "It's just annoying. We talk every day. We see each other all the time, and she's always there for me, basically. Oh my god, Amy is my best friend!" Whoa, Penny realizes it finally. Amy's dream of feeding each other's baby. This one, I must admit, was one of the funniest conversations between Amy and Penny in the show. Amy becomes furious to know that Penny doesn't want a child. Amy was angry with Penny because Penny's decision has shattered her dreams of getting pregnant at the same time being barf buddies and massaging each other's perineum. Above all, Amy expected that their babies would be BFF just like their parents. I just loved it when Penny said that Sheldon's baby would find a friend somewhere else, to which Amy gave a witty response, "Oh sure, cause Sheldon's DNA plus my DNA equals a kid who knows how to make friends. Grow up." This scene became weirder when Amy told Penny that she also dreamed that they both would breastfeed each other's babies. Amy taught Penny to be kind. Once Penny shared her high school experiences with Amy and Bernadette when she admitted that Penny was a jerk in her high school days. Penny never made up for her mean actions, so Amy decided she should push her back to be kind. Penny agrees to donate valuable stuff for charity only because Amy assured her that it was the right thing to do. Amy's maid of honor was Penny. I must admit that this was an amazing moment between Amy and Penny. Penny furiously enters her apartment to confront Amy's decision to choose Bernadette as her maid of honor. Penny shouts at Amy saying, "If you think anyone but me is going to be your maid of honor, then you're an idiot because you're my best friend." Hearing Penny's confession, Amy became so emotional that she shoved Howard aside to hug Penny. Poor Howard. He hit the fridge quite hard, and I hope he wasn't hurt. Penny talked to Sheldon about his relationship with Amy. Sheldon was quite happy to have Amy as his girlfriend, but maintained physical distance from her. So she didn't hesitate to take up the role of an aggressor and approach Sheldon directly about it. Penny openly asked Sheldon whether he would ever get physical with Amy, to which Sheldon responded that there is a possibility. I know you couldn't stop laughing at Sheldon's reply, just like me. Calling somebody your BFF is not enough. There are times when you should give an acknowledgement of this fact. Amy admitted that Penny has brought a lot of positive changes to her life and has helped her to live fully. This is what Amy said. "Before I met you, I was a mousy wallflower. Look at me now. I'm like some kind of downtown hipster party girl with a posse boyfriend." When Penny prepared Amy for her birthday surprise. Well, it was Amy's birthday and Sheldon wanted to show her how much she meant to him. Penny knew about this and took Amy out to get her waxed. Amy was confused, like, why would she need to get waxed for her birthday? That's when Penny and Bernadette broke Sheldon's plan for getting physical with Amy. Amy was so excited that she ran down the stairs to go to her waxing immediately. Penny pulled Amy out of her comfort zone. Basically, Amy's social life revolves around Penny. Remove Penny and Amy doesn't have much of a social life. Under Penny's influence, Amy became outgoing and discovered her fun-loving self. Otherwise, Amy was just the female version of Sheldon Cooper, who never had friends or social life. Everything changed when Penny came into her life. Amy ditched the gang for ditching Penny. The gang had to cut their ties with Penny when Priya demanded it. Let me remind you that it was the time when Leonard began to date Priya. Everybody ditched Penny except Amy. Amy refused to hang out with the gang until Penny was welcomed back in the gang. So guys, that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed the video. I shall say goodbye.